So, you're at a party, and someone hands you a box that could contain either a pizza or a cat. You can't open it, but you have to guess what's inside. Welcome to the world of quantum physics. So, let's start with a classic experiment that shook the foundations of physics, which is called double slit experiment. Now, imagine you have a wall with two slits, and you shoot particles, like electrons, at it. What would you expect to see on the screen behind the wall? Surprisingly, instead of seeing two bands, one behind each slit, you get an interference pattern, like the ripples you see when you drop two stones in water. This suggests that the particles are behaving like waves, but when you observe them closely, they act like particles again. This is the essence of wave-particle duality. This experiment shows that particles can exist in multiple states at once, a concept known as superposition. It's like a cat being both alive and dead at the same time until you check on it. It's called Schrodinger's cat. Now, let's dive into one of the most mind-bending phenomena in quantum physics, entanglement. So, imagine two particles that are so deeply connected that the state of one instantly affects the state of the other, no matter the distance between them. This guy, also known as Einstein, called this spooky action at a distance, but it's a real phenomenon that has been experimentally verified. When you change something about one particle, the other particle instantly changes too, even if they are far apart. Entanglement challenges our understanding of space and time, suggesting that the universe is more interconnected than your girlfriend that we ever imagined. It shows that particles can be linked in such a way that their states are dependent on each other, no matter how far apart they are. Now, if you understand entanglement, let's explore quantum tunneling, where particles cross barriers they shouldn't. Now, let's just say you're trying to walk through a solid wall. In our everyday world, that's impossible. But in the quantum world, particles can actually tunnel through barriers. This tunneling phenomenon is essential for technologies like semiconductors, which power our electronics, and even the nuclear fusion that happens in stars. Quantum tunneling demonstrates that the rules of the quantum world are very different from what we experience in our daily lives. Now, let's touch on some of the key formula that define quantum physics. Schrodinger's equation. This equation describes how the quantum state of a physical system changes over time. It's the backbone of quantum physics. So this is the formula. This equation is used when the system's energy is conserved. Hamiltonian operator psi equals to total energy psi. Now, what's the meaning of all these words? Hamiltonian operator is the operator that corresponds to the total energy of the system. It includes both kinetic and potential energy terms. Psi represents the wave function that describes the quantum state of a particle or system, and E represents the total energy of the system. Next is Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. Now, imagine trying to catch a super fast tiny ball. The harder you look to pinpoint exactly where it is, the more it bounces and jiggles around, making it harder to know how fast it's going. That's Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. It means we can't know both the exact position and the exact speed of something super small at the same time. The better we know one, the fuzzier the other becomes. Now, let's talk about quantum computing. So, what is quantum computing? Is it the big brother of computer? Imagine a computer that can explore multiple possibilities at once instead of just one at a time. That's essentially what quantum computing is. Regular computers use bits, which can either be a 0 or a 1. Quantum computers use qubits, which can be a 0, a 1, or even both at the same time. This strange ability, along with other quantum properties, allows quantum computers to solve problems that would take regular computers thousands of years to work through. It's kind of like having a superhero librarian who can read all the books at the same time, while other librarians are still reading one book at a time. Now let's explain the last topic of this video, the quantum field theory. So let's think of the universe as a giant, invisible ocean. In this ocean, particles like electrons and photons are like tiny waves or ripples. These particles are actually disturbances in their respective fields. For example, an electron is a ripple in the electron field, and a photon is a ripple in the electromagnetic field. Quantum field theory helps us understand how these ripples interact with each other, explaining the fundamental forces of nature, like electromagnetism and the strong nuclear force. Anyways, now, after watching this video, if you think I deserved like and subscribe, please do.